ATMOS Space Cargo, a German space startup working on the return of cargo from space with its Phoenix capsule, has just been granted approval by the FAA and is now scheduled for a launch in April 2025. The launch will take place on the SpaceX Bandwagon 3 rideshare mission. ATMOS uses an IAD, or Inflatable Atmospheric Decelerator device, that serves two purposes. Firstly, its expansive surface area effectively slows the capsule from orbital velocity to nearly zero upon landing. Secondly, it's designed to endure the intense heat generated during re-entry as the capsule collides with the atmosphere, creating friction and plasma. Of course, this has only been proven in tests so far. The true challenge awaits in April with its first space flight. This mission represents a milestone as the first attempt by a non-governmental European entity to achieve re-entry from space. The company aspires to break records for down mass efficiency, aiming for a payload to capsule mass ratio of 1 to 2, which is 10 times more efficient than current market standards. The capsule is set to complete two orbits around Earth before attempting re-entry. This mission marks the beginning of a series aimed at verifying that ATMOS's technology functions as intended. Let's go over in a bit more detail the objectives for the first flight. The primary goal for ATMOS is to collect essential data on the performance of the capsule and the IAD heat shield. Secondly, they will gather data from the onboard customer payloads, which include various tech demonstrations and biological experiments. The biological experiments are particularly noteworthy because the harsh conditions of re-entry, like extreme temperatures and G-forces, could easily damage sensitive biological materials unless carefully managed. Success here would boost confidence among potential customers regarding the conditions inside the re-entry capsule during the return phase. The third objective is the successful deployment and stabilization of the inflatable atmospheric decelerator, which is a cornerstone of ATMOS's cargo return strategy. While it's not expected that this initial prototype will survive re-entry, ATMOS aims to gather valuable real-world data to refine the design into a robust re-entry platform for future customer use. The first capsule can handle payloads up to 100 kilos, that's 220 pounds. The technology is scalable, with future models expected to manage significantly larger cargo, potentially decelerating several tons safely, including the return of entire first stages from orbit. SpaceX's Bandwagon missions. I've mentioned bandwagon missions from SpaceX a few times already, but never really explained what they were. Before we go into the mission, let's briefly explain what a bandwagon mission is. SpaceX has introduced scheduled missions to popular orbits, much like trains running on a fixed timetable. This approach reassures companies that if they miss one launch, another will be available in 3, 6 or 12 months. Initially, SpaceX launched the transporter missions, which targeted the most popular orbit for rideshare missions. More recently, they've added a second type of regular rideshare mission, the bandwagon missions, aimed at a different orbit. These bandwagon missions focus on mid-inclination orbits, contrasting with the sun-synchronous orbits of the transporter missions. Mid-inclination orbits are neither equatorial nor polar, but somewhere in between, typically around 45 degrees. This orbit type offers better coverage of mid-latitude regions like Asia, Europe, or the Middle East, compared to sun-synchronous orbits. Cost is also a consideration. Mid-inclination orbits can be less expensive because they require less fuel to achieve, compared to high-inclination sun-synchronous orbits. For instance, in the case of ATMOS, they care about the landing area, which will be in the Azores, an archipelago consisting of 9 islands in the North Atlantic Ocean. This is a mid-latitude location, so the bandwagon mission makes the most sense for ATMOS to use. Payloads on the test flight of ATMOS Phoenix capsule. The first test flight carries 4 payloads, including biological experiments and tech demos in microgravity. Here's what we know about 3 of those payloads so far. First up is from the German Aerospace Center, flying their M42 radiation detector. This device will measure the radiation environment during the capsule's 2 orbits around Earth before re-entry. The second payload is a bit mysterious, but it involves a Japanese company known for developing space laboratories and one-chip microscopic observation technology. It seems to be a biological or life science experiment. The third payload comes from the UK's Frontier Space, focusing on their modular and scalable lab-in-the-box technology, specifically bioreactors for in-space manufacturing. ATMOS promises more details about payloads in the near future. Sebastian Klaus, CEO and co-founder of ATMOS Space Cargo, said, "Our first test flight is what the team at ATMOS has been working towards relentlessly. I am proud to lead this mission at such a crucial moment for Europe. Our space industry needs disruptive innovation to compete on a global scale. While all eyes are on the first test flight, we are already developing the next generation of reusable spacecraft, enabling breakthroughs for biomedical research, factories in orbit, and space transportation," unquote. For a deeper understanding of ATMOS and their inflatable atmospheric decelerator, be sure to watch my video on them. The link should be on the screen now. That wraps up this video. Thank you for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.